Greetings and welcome back to Hyperspeed, the show where I try to speedrun Rage games while drinking energy drinks. This is the finale of Super Meat Boy, so prepare yourself for the most epic thing you have ever seen. Holy crap, man, I never thought we'd get here. We are on the final level. The final level of the standard game. We're not doing the Dark World because I do not want to die today. So, here we go, cracking open a new can. Last can of Bing. Last level. Let us begin! Woo! I'm so ready for this. And by that, I mean I am not ready at all. I am not prepared to die, but I'm going to 1,000 times over. So here we go. Let's just watch this cutscene. Get this one last moment of respite before hell breaks loose. And we have to end the game. Here we go. Alright, I don't remember how this game... I don't remember how this final boss works. I vaguely remember that it has something to do with dodging him. I'm gonna kill myself on that one so that I don't die there. Yeah, so I have to dodge his missiles. I have to dodge his missiles and the saws, and apparently I took too long there. That's not my can. Actually, there's still some in here. Here we go. Holy crap, guys. Alright, that one doesn't count. This one counts. Alright, here we go. I've got to make this as quick as possible because I know for a fact that I don't get much time before those saws reach that. Okay. Okay, I lost my can. Alright. Whatever. Alright, that one doesn't count because I didn't have time to prepare. I need to get in the rhythm of these things. Actually, guys, I know this is the finale, but I'm already hopped up on quite a bit of this stuff. I'm gonna stop drinking it because I'm actually concerned for my health. So you'll have to excuse me this one time. I'm not going to drink the Red Bull anymore. Not in this episode. This is the last thing. I'm done. I'm done with the drink. Because I want this to end very quickly. And quickly it shall end. As I am going to go full on, full out, all skill. I can do this. I believe in myself. Which is more than I've ever said before on this show. I don't think I've ever believed in myself before. But I believe that I can do this. I know that I can beat this. And it's gonna happen today. Maybe 6 hours from now, but it'll happen today. And I'm gonna do it. And there's gonna be no stupid editing tricks. Only cool ones. Ha 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 ha. Get it? But no unnecessary speeding up of things. I'm only going to speed things up when I actually have to because I don't have anything to say. If I even get to that point. But let's be honest, I'm going to get to that point because I'm definitely going to run out of things to say before I beat this level. Because this level will take me years to beat. I remember I spent days on this thing in high school when I first played this game and finally beat it. And I believe that I can do this. But this is insanity, and it requires you to memorize every movement and do everything in one shot. And I've done it before, and I vaguely remember how I did it last time, so that's the only reason I think I have any chance. But that's why I'm gonna do it. Ready? See. Oh, okay. Whatever. So this is the final boss. Holy crap. Dr. Fetus, the villain of this story, which I still have theories that it may have something to do with abortion. It's gotta. There's no way you can have a fetus as a villain and not be in some way saying something about abortion. I'm just putting it out there, man. Just stating the obvious here. So it seems as long as I jump these things in time, his rockets don't seem to hurt me, so that seems to be fine. And I'm getting a bit farther every time, and hopefully I can just keep going until eventually I make it. I think I can do this. I really do. I really believe in myself for once. For the first time since I started this, I think I can do this. I'm coming off of a really hard level last time, and I can do this, man. I can do this. I gotta keep the positivity up because there is no way I'm going to make it through this without losing my mind unless I keep that positivity up. I keep that happy attitude, happy-go-lucky, cheery attitude, and jump over these saws like they're nothing. Like they are nothing, man. There is no chance. I'm gonna beat this level like clockwork. I'm gonna beat it like it's nothing. I'm gonna sit back and relax and chill because I know I can do this. And I'm just gonna focus on playing the game and talking and saying whatever comes into my mind. Right now, what's in my mind is, I can do this. So that's what I'm gonna say. I can do this. I know this entire game is just memorization. It's just memorization. That's all it is. It's just a whole bunch of memorization. It's nothing but was that a full can? Is one of these a full can? Sorry. Thought I knocked over a full can for a second. It's just a whole bunch of memorization and quick reflexes, and those are two things I can do. I can memorize patterns, and I can react fast. Those are the two things you need for this game, and I can do it. I'm just not as good at doing the pixel perfect jumping, but that's okay, because I can figure it out through memorization. I just gotta figure out what I gotta do at every turn. I don't know why I did that. That was stupid. So much for memorization, I jumped straight into the blade, knowing it was gonna come there. See, I can trick his rocket, I can hop here, his rocket can't get me here, now I have the wall, now I have that wall before that comes, now I just make it through here, this part's easy, this part is a piece of cake, it's nothing man, it's not even a challenge, you know? It's not even a challenge, man. This is nothing to me. Nothing at all. See, I got there before it even wanted me to. I'm gonna drop right down in here. I'm gonna hop over these blades. I'm gonna do this, man. I believe in myself. I can do it. I can't do it. Alright, no, seriously, though. I know I can do it. I'm getting farther and farther with each try, and that one, I got surprisingly far. I was starting to think this was going to be a miracle where I beat it in like 2 seconds and then there's like nothing else to do for the rest of this episode. I was actually getting concerned that this was going to be the shortest thing of all time. I know I can do this though. I know it's long. I know it's long and I know it's hard. And I know that makes you think of dicks. I know that sounds like I'm talking about something phallical in nature. But this game, I mean, it dicks me over, sure, but it's not a dick, but it is long and hard. Like one. Like mine. No, okay, sorry. Didn't need to give you that imagery, I know. I mean, if you're into that, then like, hey, hit me up, right? I don't judge. But yeah. Sorry, I'm wicked focused. I know I can do it on this. I can do it on this go if I know. If I do it right. I know it. I just know it. Okay. I don't know it. That's fine. That's perfectly fine. It's like, you know, this gives me memories of Sephiroth from frickin' Kingdom Hearts. You know Kingdom Hearts 2, how Sephiroth is like the impossible boss. And you do it like a billion times and it makes you rage, but then you figure out the pattern of how he's gonna attack, and you figure out that at the beginning you gotta press triangle first thing or he's gonna kill you immediately. It's the same thing here. You gotta jump right off the start or he's gonna kill you immediately. It's the trick at the beginning, the little trick up, just there so you know this is serious, that there's a trip up right at the beginning. And look, I was gonna say this is easy, but then I jumped right off the edge like an idiot, so whatever. But I'm not an idiot. I know I can do this. I know it for a fact. And idiots don't know things for facts. I'm smarter than that. I know and I believe I can do this. Come on. Come on. Come on. You see that awesome jump there? That little clip up? I killed myself anyway, but did you see that the way I did that? I just jump roped that thing. Like it was nothing. Like it was nothing. Like I was, what's that jump rope, frickin', the thing that schoolgirls do when they jump rope, they sing something. It's a little rhyme for that. I don't know why I did that, that was stupid. Alright, here we go. I believe in it. I believe in myself. Here we go, satellite radio. You know? I figured out the timing, I figured out the pattern, that's all this is. It's just timing and patterns. I've already got it figured out. I've got life figured out, man. I can do this. This isn't even a challenge for me anymore. You know the hardships I have faced. You think you are a challenge for me, final level? You think you can beat me after everything I've done? After all the work I've put into this? You think you can demotivate me and beat me today? You can't. This is it. This is it for you, game. You're about to be beaten. Beaten senseless. You're about to witness true skill. I say as I jump into a blade. Come on, man. Come on. Keep the positivity up. I am positive that I just died. Come on, man. I can do this. I don't know why that happened right there. I'm pretty sure that was a glitch. Gonna blame it on glitches. Because it sure as heck was not me. Because I can do this, man. This is perfectly within my skill set. Years from now, when my potential employer asks me, do you have any special skills? This is the video to show them, man. This is the video. These are the skills I have. Motivation. Belief in myself. Determination. I am frisky up in here. You know, Frisk from Undertale. Just determination. It's a joke. It's a lame joke, but it's a joke. I'm getting frisky up in here. I got determined. Never give up. Trust your instincts. Peppy has taught me well. All of my training, all of my gaming experience to this moment brings me to this. Everything I've learned has brought me to this moment. This moment when I will finally beat Super Meat Boy. Well, for the second time. I've beaten it before. Finally beat it on screen, where everybody can see how amazing I am at this, as I say as I jump right into a thing. I can do this. This is going to happen. I need no miracles for this. I will beat this by sheer force of will, I say as I die sooner than I ever have before. This is easy, man. This is nothing. This is a cakewalk. I'm literally walking on cake. You don't believe me? I'll show you my shoes when I'm done with this. They're made of cake. Believe me. Look at that thing sailed right over my head. You think you can hit me with that? You think with your crappy aim, Dr. Fetus, you can hit me? I didn't even have to dodge that one. You missed. You just missed on your own. And you don't think I can beat you? I will show you. I will show you what I'm capable of. You don't want to see what I'm capable of, but I will show you. And you will be impressed. And you will be awestruck. And you will be defeated. As soon as I stop doing stupid things like that. Because I know this is possible. I know I have what it takes. This is my final challenge, my final test. This is the very last thing. This is the be-all and end-all of skill. No participation ribbons here. Only, no second or third place, only first. I will defeat you. Game, I will take that ribbon from you. I will show you who's boss. You want to know who's boss? I'm the boss. I want that blue ribbon. Blue ribbon's first place, right? I don't know. Whatever color is first place, I'm gonna take it. I'm gonna take that ribbon with the big old number one on it. It's gonna be shimmering in gold. It's gonna be a big ass trophy. One of those trophies that has three freaking pillars in the trophy, because you know that that's the first place trophy. You know the biggest one. The biggest one. It's gonna be three levels of trophy. And on the top, there's gonna be a guy. And that guy's gonna be made of meat. And that meat is probably going to rot very quickly over time. And get gross. And then I'm gonna have to eventually throw that trophy out. But I assure you, I'm gonna win that trophy. I don't care. I'm gonna win the trophy and all the glory that comes with it. The glory of finally having defeated the infamous Dr. Fetus. I will beat you. I will beat you to a pulp. I will beat you so bad that Samuel L. Jackson will be afraid to look at your corpse. And he's shot a motherfucker like it's nothing. That man, I'll beat you so bad that the killer from Seven, the freaking killer from Seven will be grossed out by how much you're beaten. You don't want to know. You don't want to know what I'm going to do to you. You can't even fathom it. You can't even fathom how much you're going to be beaten when I'm done with you. Because you know I'm going to beat you. You know it, and you're scared, Meat Boy. Not Meat Boy. The game, Meat Boy. Hello, internetians, and welcome back to Hyperspeed, the show where I try to speedrun rage games while drinking energy drinks. I mean, not hello, because this isn't the beginning of the episode. I'm just going to put this on the end of the last one. This is definitely the same recording session. No time passed at all. Ignore the fact that my hair is wet, and ignore the fact that I'm at the title screen again. So nothing's going on. I don't know what you're talking about. Actually, all joking aside, I ran out of time to record that one day, so I didn't get to finish the final level. So I'm gonna go back and do that. That's gonna be this entire episode. I don't know why I'm saying that like this is the beginning of the episode. You know this already. Okay, let's go on. Alright, so, to get myself hyped up like I was last time, and I'm only pretending to be hyped up really fast right now while I'm speaking in like lightning speed like a fucking idiot. I actually have not drank anything yet, so I'm going to chug this thing of being energy juice rather than drinking it with each death, because I need to immediately get back to that place. That way I can quickly and efficiently finish this last level without having to take a break to take a drink. I'm gonna beat it. I'm gonna beat it quickly because I have to go to work, and before that I would like to see Nathan off before he leaves, as he's going back to college. So that being said, let's start this. Let's move on. We all know it took me 3 hours to beat level 5. I've got about 2 hours to beat the final level. So wish me luck. Oh god, this is gonna kill me. Too much caffeine in my system, my heart's gonna fucking explode. Oh god. Alright, I'm ready. We're ready. Let's do this. Alright, let's see if I can remember how to play this. I know, last time, I had a pattern down. If I can get that down again... What the hell? I was pretty sure I dodged that, but that's fine. Anyway, if I can get that pattern down again, I should be fine. Okay, off to a great start, guys. Nowhere near as good as I was doing last time. Maybe I should just take this slow and not use the frickin' speed boost thing at all. I'm gonna use it when I need it. I don't need it very often, so that should be... Okay, I'm an idiot. I was in free fall when he did that, which means he hit me. Alright, I can do this. It should be easy. Okay, I say as I immediately jump into a spike. Pray to God that the controller glitch doesn't happen and that there's no lag to the screen, because that's what's going to kill me, if anything. God damn it. Alright. I was really hoping I would be able to get right into the mood and do this immediately, but it does not seem that's going to happen, so prepare Uranus for a very long episode, I say, as this is the middle of the episode, because I've already been doing this for a while. Alright, yep. I think there is a slight delay in my- what the fuck? Okay, that clearly did not hit me, I'm just going to tell you that. Okay, that one did hit me, because I'm an idiot. There is a slight delay between my controls and what happens on the screen, so that's probably gonna screw me a few hundred times, but you know, no big deal. It's not like this is frickin' timed or anything. Motherfucker. Okay, here we go. Let's move on. Alright, I'm gonna try and be chill for as long as I possibly can. I'm gonna try and relax because I believe I can do this, but I don't know how long that's gonna last, man. God damn it. Alright, here we go, satellite radio, y'all getting hit with the boom, boom, motherfucker, I got boomed. Alright. As soon as he jumps, I know I jump. Then I get down here. So that he, in the trenches where he can't shoot me. Use this boost to get up here, motherfucker. Use the boost to get through! God damn it! Alright, don't worry, I can do this. It's doable. Father Mucker! God... Doggammit. Alright, here we go. Whoo! That was a slick dodge right there, I'll say. I must say. If I do say so myself, I say so myself, I do say. Alright, cool. We are in the next section, and I'm an idiot. Okay. In other words, nothing has changed. Okay. I can do this. I believe I can do this. I'm gonna frickin' do this because I have to do this because this has been tormenting me for ages. I have been playing this game for like over a year now, trying to beat this one frickin' level. Actually, I've been making a lot of progress recently. This is not the one level I've been trying to beat for years. I've been... only on this level for a short time. I actually was in previous levels for quite a while, and I finally beat them and made some progress, so... Motherfucker! Okay, I need to stop using the boost there, because it's screwing me. Speed this part up. Alright, I'm a little bit farther than- Fuck this in. Okay, so I'm making progress gradually. I'm getting a little bit farther each time. Except for that time when I didn't get anywhere because I'm an idiot. I didn't even try to dodge that one. I don't know why I dodged it so easily. Alright, so here we go. I am pretty sure I can do this now. I am ready. Ooh, that was close. Man, I'm getting... This is so freaking hard, man. Alright, so... I'm making a little bit of progress. Luckily, I made that jump terribly. That was horrible. I do not deserve to live. God damn it. Well, I got what I deserved, which was, of course, death. The opposite of living. So here we go. So, what I figured out last time is that, I mean, this isn't something you have to figure out. This is something you always know, is that Meat Boy is a pattern. You just have to memorize the pattern. You have to figure out what you have to do and when, and then just do it flawlessly. So you'll notice that, like, usually there's blood in the exact same sections of the frickin' walls. That's because I always have to do the exact same thing. And when I find something that works, I can do it. I can just keep doing that. So all I have to do is not do anything stupid, and I should be fine. That being said, I do have a tendency to do lots of stupid things, so maybe I will not be fine. Like that, that was pretty stupid. So what I haven't figured out yet is the pattern for that section. I already have the pattern down for these things. These saws are not even remotely a threat to me anymore. The only threat to me there is my own stupidity, which, as you can see, comes up quite often. But as long as I don't do anything stupid there, which of course I immediately regret and announce that I am stupid, like there, that was pretty stupid. I just straight up missed that platform, like a frickin' idiot. As long as I don't do anything completely idiotic, I should be fine in this section. I say as I do something completely idiotic. But, as long as I don't do what I'm currently doing, I should win. All I have to do is not do what I'm doing. Because what I'm doing is clearly wrong. Alright, so, yeah. I don't know what I'm saying anymore. So, the idea is that eventually I should memorize the pattern for this entire freaking map and figure out how to beat it. I can't do it. I can definitely not do it once I'm chopped up into little bits of myself. Little bits of meat. I mean, I'm already a little bit of meat, but like, littler bits of meat. And like, plural. And like, not with arms and legs intact. So, this part is not too hard. I really should not use the boost here. I mean, I should use it here, because I have to get over that gap. And here, because I have to get over this gap. But on those little platforms, I don't need it. And so, it kind of screws me. And they screwed me there too, but that was my own fault. I just did the timing wrong. I like how, when I fall down here, it seems like sometimes he launches the rocket into the ground and sometimes he launches it over my head, but I'm usually pretty safe. Like, one of those two things is going to happen, and it doesn't really matter which one, because I usually don't get hit by it regardless. The rockets are not all that much of a threat at this point, to be honest, mainly because I'm able to keep him. I've been, so far, able to keep him behind me. God damn it, I was so close. If I dropped a second later, I would have landed in the right timing between those saws, which is what I've been trying to do. I've been trying to figure out the timing of those saws so that I can get past that section, because that section has been the big thing screwing me so far. Why did I do that? I don't even need the boost there. I held the boost, and that's what... Like, the boost not only makes you move faster, it also makes you fall faster, so it kind of evens out. And in that case, I just couldn't control myself well enough to do it. Okay, boost, no boost. Yeah. That part's kind of annoying. While I have figured it out, it's mildly annoying because I have to release the boost, like, after the first part of the jump. Which is just mildly difficult to do. It's not an entirely difficult thing, but it's just a little bit. And these stupid saws on the side keeping me at a particular pace are really annoying too, because I can't go... First of all, I can't fall behind, because as soon as I fall behind, I'm dead. But also, I can't get too far ahead, so I can't get into a rhythm as easily in this level. This game just, like, a lot of the difficulty of this game, as I've stated before, comes from, it breaks your rhythm. Like, it's a game where you need to get into a rhythm, but it breaks your rhythm and it makes you have to stop and think for a second. It's a very well-designed game, actually, and I used the boost again, and I'm an idiot. I don't know why I did that. I really don't. I honestly don't. I also don't know why I jumped there, because if I jumped just once, I would have been fine, but I jumped twice like an idiot. Because that's what I am. I am an idiot, therefore I must do idiot things. Here we go. Alright, we're good. We're good so far. I used the boost there again, which I didn't need to, but that's okay, I made it. The boost doesn't automatically kill me in that section, it just makes it harder for me to make the jump. Just makes it harder for me to control myself. To contain my utter rage for this game right now, which I'm doing quite well, as you might notice. I am not fully raging yet, therefore I'm doing quite a decent job of containing my rage. And there's quite a bit of it. I'm a large container for rage. There's a lot of leeway. It takes a while before my rage bursts out, but as you've probably seen in previous episodes, that will eventually happen. It is inevitable. It is inevitable, Mr. Anderson. Okay, that was just me being stupid. I was screwing around waiting for him to launch the missile, and I shouldn't have been. I should have just been patiently waiting for him to launch the missile. See, this is why this game combined with Red Bull and the pressure of doing it on camera is not a good combination, because it gets me like, all right, let me do it, come on. I lose that patience which is semi-required to play this game. There is a certain level of patience. I don't know about like the rest of the game, not always. Some levels require a lot of patience. This one is one of them, for sure. And that is something I do not have, which is probably why this last level took me like 400 tries the first time I played it. Oh yeah, and that thing I did where I sped everything up in the previous episode, yeah, I'm not doing that again. Mainly because this episode would get so fast that the world would break, not just the sound. And then I would have to replace the world with Guile's theme, and that just wouldn't work. Like, I don't think you can... I mean, I guess it goes with everything. But does it go with nothing? That's the question. Because nothing would be what was left of the world if my rage got loose from this game. If I did that. Alright, I'm getting a little bit quiet because I'm getting close to the part where I always screw up. So, I'm going to try and not talk for a second, if that's fine with all of you. If I can have your permission to die. You have my permission to die. I hope everyone here has seen Badman. I believe that's the official title of it. If it's not official, it is at least my unofficial title for it. The College Humor Batman videos, because they are freaking hilarious, let me tell you. They are some of the funniest things I've ever seen. If you haven't seen those, leave this open and open that in the new tab and freaking check that out, because that is, those videos are the shit, man. Not shit, man, like the superhero. Although he is a pretty shitty superhero, I must admit. That version of Batman. God damn it, I went right into the frickin' saws again. Alright, I can do this. It's not even hard, man. It's not even hard. It's all memorization. Memorization is something I can do, alright? You hear me? Actually, honestly, memorization is not my strong suit. I'm more of a, calculation type of person. So I've always been better at math than something like geography or history. I can't do geography or history very well because it requires a lot of memorization. Probably why this game makes me rage so much, and why I've never been particularly good at it. I've just been okay at it. Like, I could play it, right? And I've beaten it before. And I will do it again. But until that happens, I am not the best. I will be the best once I beat this game. At that point, I will claim to be the best. I will not be, but I will claim to be. And then I will feel better about myself, because right now I feel like garbage for not being able to beat this frickin' game. It's so frickin' hard, I hate it. Motherfucker! Okay, here we go. I'm trying to keep it PG, but that's clearly not happening anymore. That's clearly beyond my capabilities. I don't think I'm able to keep this PG. It's gonna get a little wild, let's be honest. Let's be honest. That's an old Pitch Perfect reference, which is weird because it's a weird movie for me to reference, but it's actually pretty funny. So, to be fair, while it does initially seem like a chick flick, it's pretty goddamn funny. It's kind of like She's the Man. If you've ever seen She's the Man, that movie looks like it's a chick flick, right? Because it's about a female character, and she's going to college, and there's dating related stuff in it, and it's about her dreams playing football, and it seems like something that, like, your girlfriend would bring you out to watch, right? Like it's not got the action and the awesomeness that a lot of movies that men enjoy. Not to be sexist, you can enjoy chick flicks. I enjoy myself an occasional chick flick, but it's not my thing. I'm more of an action movie guy. But it's not got the action and the craziness and the blood and gore that you expect from like a movie like Kill Bill, which is a fantastic movie, mind you. And you don't have to be a man to watch it, but you're not a man if you don't watch it. No, I'm kidding about that, but it doesn't have that stuff, right? But man, is it funny. It is honestly one of the funniest movies I've ever seen. I am on a roll right now. Okay, now I am on a saw, which is rolling across my flesh and sawing it open. But yeah. No, I just figured I'd take a second to point out the fact that I'm doing good, just to jinx myself, just to screw myself over. Because if I beat it this quickly, man, that would be such a disappointment, wouldn't it? Wouldn't it really suck if I could just finally freaking beat this game? Wouldn't that be the worst? Man, I hope to God I never beat this game. I hope it never happens. Please, I'm begging you, God. I know you hate me, so hopefully you'll do the opposite of what I'm saying. I'm begging you, man. Just don't ever let this game end. It's an endless game. I love it. I could just play this forever. For freaking ever. Yeah, so back at the beginning, here we go. Big surprise. Big freaking surprise, man. I'm so shocked. Actually, I was sawed, not shocked, but still. Okay. Time to focus. I'm gonna do this part without talking too much. I'll talk a little bit, but not too much. There's a limit to my talking. I always talk too much, honestly. It's part of the reason why I decided to start doing Let's Plays is because my specialty is talking an obnoxious amount. And that's basically what Let's Players do. They play games, and they say an obnoxious amount of shit until eventually something funny comes out of their mouth, and then people go, haha, they're geniuses. When really, they just don't know what they're saying at the time. I know the feeling. I know Markiplier. I know I don't usually bring him up. I've been trying to not bring him up. I don't watch him anymore, actually. I was more Game Grumps for a while, and now I actually kind of don't watch many other Let's Players, but all respect to these guys. They're big. They're way bigger than me. I love these guys. I know for a fact that Markiplier has admitted before that sometimes he just doesn't know what's coming out of his mouth. I know that the Game Grumps have also said that they've looked back at old videos and been like, I said that? And I totally know what they mean, because, like, I was watching an old, when I started re-editing Hyperspeed again, after a while, after I'd been away from it for a while, the last video I edited, I was like, I said that crap? Like, it was just like, it was funny, man. It was some of my better material, and I was just like, when did I say this stuff? Is that really me? But yeah, I understand that feeling of, like, just, I don't know what I'm saying right now. I think sometimes that's the best stuff. Like I said, that was some of my best material. Was just, I didn't know what the hell I was talking about. And it just made me laugh, because I was just surprised that this stuff would come out of my mouth. Just all these weird comparisons, and, like, things about the devil, like, frickin' hating Meat Boy, and, like, man, I got pretty into that one, I might say. Alright, so I think that section right there, to change the topic real quick, I think that section right there where I've died the last two times, or whatever, the farthest section I've gotten to yet, I think what I have to do is jump off from the wall, but then don't immediately try to cross, because the saw on the other side is lower. If I immediately try to cross, I'll die. So what I'm thinking, and this is just a theory, again! No, sorry, I'll stop now. This is just a theory, but what I'm thinking is that if I jump and then sort of let myself free fall a bit before I do it, like that was a demonstration of free falling. That definitely wasn't me failing to press the button in time. That was my demonstration of free falling. I meant to do that. My point being, if I free fall for a second first, and then I try to go to the other side, then maybe I can do it. That's gonna be the next thing I try anyway. Time isn't. It's only just past 12. I have time. To put this in perspective, I have to be done with this by at least, at the latest, 2. 2 is the latest I can possibly still be playing this. And I'm really hoping I can finish this today so it's done once and for all. And also so I don't have 4 freaking clips to cut together for this one episode. I noticed my tone, my attitude probably changed midway through this episode because it's a new day and I'm in a new mood. A newer, bigger mood. Alright, so I think I figured that section out at least. Though it's still, honestly, partly just dumb luck. I still feel like I'm not 100% sure what I'm supposed to do there. Alright, yeah, so that's what I have to do there. So that was the correct solution, what I just did. Except for, you know, the part where I died. Except for the part where I died, where... Yeah, I'm gonna have to figure out how to make that jump now, which I'm guessing I was on the right track, that I have to use the boost and jump away from that wall, because that seems to be the only way to get over there, and the boost will allow me to get farther, which it looks like I will definitely need to get as far as possible. But I'm pretty sure I need to go a little bit lower and time that jump a little bit later so that I can... I am an idiot. I used the boost again at that part. Use the boost to get through! Sorry. I slowly turn into video game references, just a cluster of video game references when I do this, which I mean, I don't think is necessarily a bad thing, but it might make me seem like I'm entirely mentally insane, and especially if you don't know what I'm talking about. If you don't know all my obscure references, actually that one's not obscure, that one's pretty mainstream, but if you don't know all my references, you might think I'm completely mentally insane. You might think I have, like, schizophrenia. Is that the one where you have multiple personalities and you just switch between them weirdly? Because that's what you probably think I have, if you don't get my references. But no, I forgot what I was saying. Something about using the boost to get through. Yeah, that is Peppy from Star Fox. If I haven't given you enough time to figure it out on your own, that is the answer to what that comes from, if you were wondering. You know, I have Mass Effect and Breath of the Wild I could be playing, and instead I'm playing this crap. I mean, no offense to Team Meat. Let me be, for once in the lifetime of Hyperspeed, let me be entirely honest. This game's actually really cool. It's really well made. I think this game is great. It's just, I don't want to be playing it right now, because, first of all, it's beginning to make me angry. And the other reason is because I have 2 fantastic new games that just released. A lot of people would disagree with me in the case of Mass Effect, but personally I still think it's good. I understand why people have an issue with it. I see its flaws. I guess I'm just better at ignoring them than most people. That's all. But I have 2 great new games that I could be playing, and I'm really into. But instead I have to do this because of freaking Hyperspeed, man. You know, after this, I'm gonna quit Hyperspeed for a long time. Partially because I'm pretty sure all the caffeine is literally killing me. Like, it's literally causing my heart stress, which is going to kill me inevitably. But also partially because I just want to take a break and do other things, alright? God, why did I do that? Why did I do that? Also, why did I do that? That's gotta be the weirdest death. Not the worst. But definitely the weirdest death that's occurred yet. I need to quit Hyperspeed for a while after this. I'm probably gonna start a side series. I'm probably gonna do Kingdom Hearts for a while, to be honest. For a while after this. And that I'm not going to down a ton of energy drinks to do. Because I'd like to live. And also because while Kingdom Hearts is a challenging game, it is not the hyperspeed type of difficult. It's not the type of game that I think energy drinks would make more interesting, personally. I think it's more of something where I can talk more personally about, like, my history with the game, because it's very nostalgic for me, you know? And all the characters and, like, Disney knowledge that I know of, which is not as much as you might think. I'm more of a video game and action movie type of person, as I've previously said. And that also extends to my random trivia knowledge. It also is more about video games and action movies than it is about, what was I saying? Than it is about Disney movies. I know a few things about Disney movies, right? Like, for example, just a couple to ruin your childhood. Lion King is a retelling of Hamlet, first of all. And originally, Scar was supposed to, like, have a... Scar was supposed to have a thing with Nala, I think, if I remember correctly. I think he still kind of does, but it was supposed to be a lot more, like, weird and explicit originally. But anyway, yeah, Lion King's just a retelling of Hamlet. And, also, Chicken Run's about the Holocaust, in case nobody figured that out. It's kind of obvious, but when you're a kid, you don't get it, you know? But, like, just take a second and think about that, because it's true. It really is. They're in a freaking concentration camp. I mean, seriously. They made a children's movie about the Holocaust and got away with it. And I mean, that's what I respect about Disney movies, is that they can take on these serious topics without just being totally over the top and unnecessarily, like they can still be a kid's movie while taking on serious topics. And I think that's why both kids and adults like Disney movies. And I can't blame them. I gotta say, I do like... I mean, Disney movies are fantastic, and I especially like ones like, My Death. That's a Disney movie. You just watched it. If you don't believe me, just go back 1 second and you can rewatch My Death. Alright, so anyway. No, I really like, Zootopia, personally. Because I feel like it's the first Disney movie in a long while that has taken on topics as serious and as relevant and as universal as... race issues and just the issues that are going on with the police and everything, and just it's about acceptance of, like, race and gender, and she's the first bunny cop, obviously, it's, you know, but, and everyone's like, yeah, bunnies can't be cops. I mean, like I'm not gonna spell it out. If you don't understand that, then, like, watch the movie a little bit and pay attention, because you'll figure it out. It's a great movie. It's also really well written, and it's the first Disney movie in a long time to really surprise me with its plot twist, which I won't ruin for you, because, like I said, it's a great movie. But just watch it. It's good. Alright, I'm gonna take a second to be quiet and try this. God damn it, I was so close. Okay, so I think I've figured out that section, right? I have officially figured out what I was supposed to do there. I'm pretty sure I know. Let me just focus on it, and I should be able to get through, alright? Give me a minute. God damn it, okay. So, I'm gonna do a few quiet tries and see if I can't beat it. Because I feel like I've been practicing multitasking, both talking and doing this at the same time, and I feel like if I quiet down and try really hard, I might be able to beat it in a couple tries. So just give me a few tries. If it gets to be too many of them, I'll speed it up until, like, the last couple, and then, yeah, you'll see anyway. I'll shut up. No, see, I need to go later on that one. I keep jumping the gun on it. I need to jump a couple times. It's okay, so when I get down there, the saw is gonna go up. And then the timing I figured out is I need to go down so that the saw is down when I land. And the reason why is because at that point I will have a second to hit the ground and jump, and I should be able to jump over that saw and land on the platform, which is what I have been doing, and why it's so stupid that I keep failing to do it. Okay, I need to be a little bit sooner than that, but that was the right idea. Trying to get the pattern down, because that's really all it is. It's memorization, this game. I know I've said that. I'm probably going to say it like 4 more times because I'm an idiot with not much to say. But this game just, it's hard to focus, you know? I understand the pain of YouTubers trying to talk and frickin' play a game like this. It's difficult. Okay, that was just stupid of me. I just took too long on that one. I'm just gonna give some minor semi-play-by-play commentary on myself for a bit. And try to be quiet when there's nothing particularly interesting going on. I've been talking about weird things like Disney movies for too long. I'm gonna focus on the game and hopefully not do something stupid like that. Because that was pretty stupid. Okay, that was just really stupid of me. Alright. I don't even have to explain what I did wrong there. It was really obvious and really stupid. Hey, so, you've probably noticed, Mr. Cherub, many nicknames on our channel, has been playing Resident Evil 7. I'd like to hear feedback, preferably in the comments on that video, actually, because it'll make more sense there. But, if you guys want to tell me what you think of, Jaren's playthrough of that yet, whether he's taking too long going through sections, or just like if you think he's funny. I mean, he is kind of like if you guys have seen the Mass Effect first impressions video I did for Mass Effect Andromeda, he's kind of like that. He's kind of like me without energy drinks. That is to say, he does not talk nearly as much as he probably should for a Let's Play. But I mean, if you guys don't mind that, if you guys like focus on the game, then I'll try to do that, especially with games like Kingdom Hearts, where I'm not going to be on energy drinks. I will not force myself to talk as much. It'll be a little bit more relaxing for me, and if you guys want me to just focus on the game, then that's definitely something I can do. I'm pretty ready, honestly, to play Kingdom Hearts, but I'm just gonna, before that, I need to at least beat Mass Effect Andromeda, because that's just my personal game right now. I'm not doing a recording of that or anything, if you think that's what I mean, but I feel like that, once I've completed that, is when I'll be ready to move on with my life and do other things. Because, I mean, that's a very heavy game, and I feel like I want to focus on that personally. I just really like Mass Effect for its, like, seriousness and just how good it is. It's a good game. Oh, so to talk about the issues that people have with Mass Effect, because I brought that up earlier, but I didn't really say anything about it. A lot of people have issues with the animations, but the animations don't bother me so much because, I mean, I can deal with them because I've always liked Mass Effect for its story and its characters, which I will admit, its characters in Andromeda are not as good as the characters in 1, 2, and 3. Okay, actually, I'm going to shut up for a second. Give me a minute. Okay, I have to do that quick. This is all about dodging the missiles. This is where the missiles are really going to be the threat. God damn it, I was so close. Wait, did it count? It's showing a cutscene. Does that mean I've won? Did I win? Holy crap, I think I might have done it. That was not as hard as I thought it would be, actually. I thought there was going to be more to that level. I thought that was just like a halfway point or something. Oh, wait a second. Yep, he's doing a thing. He is sure as hell doing a thing. No, it looks like the level's over anyway. Oh no! Okay. End run. Speaking of Mass Effect, here's your end run. What? What do I do here? God damn it. Alright, I can do this though. This is gonna be it. This is gonna be my glorious escape. This is doable. This is something I can actually pull off, I think. I mean, that jump right there is like pixel perfect. So that's kind of painful. But I know I can do it. Holy crap, I can't believe I've made it as far as I have. I'm just glad it's not making me go back and replay that previous section. But you know what this means? This means that I have to beat this today, because I don't think I can replay this without replaying that previous section. Which means if I don't beat this today, I'm gonna have to redo that entire section again. And that is not something I want to do, let me tell you. God damn it, okay. Let me try and... I'm pretty sure I need to use the boost there, but let me try and not use it just once. Okay, that was stupid. That was... I'm still gonna try and not use it because I didn't even get the chance to. Also, I just killed myself in the dumbest, most amateur way possible, let me point out. Okay, yeah, I definitely need to use the boost there to get low enough. But the question is, how much do I need to jump and when? I'm gonna boost at the last second so that I don't... So that it makes the falling timing easier, because if you boost, like I said, you fall faster, and that applies to when you're touching walls as well. I can time the jump better if I'm not boosting on that wall, but I have to press both the boost and jump button at the same time. God damn it, okay. It needs to be a short jump, I guess. I'm gonna have to short jump it. Okay, well, not like that. I pressed the boost too early and I just fell. God damn it. Okay, I need to take my time on this. I am panicking, I'm wasting time by being too... Yes! Okay, so short jump there. Motherfucker. Okay, this is hard, man. That jump right there, those saws are gonna be difficult. I have at least figured out what I have to do there, though. It's a short jump. I have to short jump it. So, I'm gonna jump, get down here. Short jump. Okay, I can't do that. So what I have to do... Okay, I'm an idiot. I keep doing that. I keep not jumping far enough on that one. I just have to max that one out. Okay. Okay, I think I have... Okay, I have to get over that saw. The question is how. Do I use the boost to do that? Do I use the boost to get through? Okay, that saw is going to be really difficult to get around. It's going to be like getting around this one, which I just did, so it proves that it's possible. Why did I long jump that? I'm sorry. That was my bad. I just did a dumb there. I'm so freaking close, man. I am so unbelievably close. I am edging right here. This is just incredible. I'm kind of pissed at myself a little bit, to be honest, actually, for doing what I just did. At least I don't have the saws. I don't think I even have a limited time on this one. I think I can take my time with this. God damn it. Okay, I need to release. I'm pulling towards the wall a little too much. I need to release for just a second. And then do it. That jump is just so pixel perfect. I hate it. This one is, and then that one is. I overjumped that. I held it. I should not have held it. God damn it, okay. I'm an idiot, I just fell back to the start. Like, why even kill myself when I can just fall back to the start? And I overjumped it again. Alright, I'm gonna be quiet for a second and see if I can do this. God damn it, okay. So I have some time. This is clearly not gonna be done in a couple tries. So allow me to continue my talking about my random trivia knowledge of movies. Did you know that Darth Vader never said, "Luke, I am your father"? The actual line was, "No, I am your father." I mean, if you've actually watched Star Wars, you might know that, but, like, which is like everyone. Pretty much everyone's seen Star Wars. But it's just an interesting fact, because everyone always quotes it as, Luke, I am your father. But it's actually, no, I am your father, because the context is, he says, did Obi-Wan tell you about your father or whatever? And he's like, he told me enough. He told me you killed him. And then Darth Vader is like, no, I am your father. And then Luke's like, no, but everyone knows that part. Yeah, it's really weird that everyone knows the quote that didn't actually happen. Funny quote, another thing about a famous quote that's kind of funny is in the first Lord of the Rings movie, Fellowship of the Ring. I can't do this and talk. Okay, in the first Lord of the Rings movie. Everyone knows, because of the meme that spawned from it, everyone knows the quote, one does not simply walk into Mordor. Only here's the problem. After trekking around and trying to be stealthy about it for like three movies and getting part of their team killed, in the third movie they kind of just walk into Mordor. So, I mean, like, that's a technicality, I guess. You could say I'm wrong about that. But I'm pretty sure they pretty much just do it. Like, it's not that simple. But they really do just kind of walk in Mordor, in a way. In the first Karate Kid movie, I'm talking about the original, not the remake, which is debatably better or worse depending on who you ask. In the first Karate Kid movie, Mr. Miyagi teaches the Karate Kid the famous unblockable attack, which is really honestly just a crane stance and a step stool kick. Not that impressive, but the funny thing is that in the second movie, a guy blocks it and throws him on his ass. So yeah, that's Karate Kid for you. If you wanted me to ruin Karate Kid for you, there it is. Okay, I'm here. I'm going to shut up. Okay, fall perfectly. Okay, I can do this, I swear. Alright. I'm just gonna focus on this for a second. Okay, shit. Okay. I know how to do that, though, now. I have seen the timing. I don't know why I had to die in order to see the timing, but I have seen the timing. And also, me getting over that stall right there was total luck. No idea how I did it. So that's always good. The thing that's been killing me for like 4 hours and I finally got past. Yeah, I didn't figure out how to get past it. That was luck. I just kind of made it. The thing is, that one is not a pattern, let me tell you. That one is just pixel perfect. You just have to do it right. It's not something you can figure out. You just have to do it. I understand how to do it. I have understood what I'm supposed to do there for almost the entire time I've been there. The question is not a question. That was a stupid statement. The question is not a question. No. I was going to say the question is, but it's not a question because... Frick, because I already know the answer. I know how to get past it. The fact of the matter is, it's just a pixel-perfect jump, and I just have to time it flawlessly, which is really hard to do in this game, if you couldn't tell. This is a very difficult game when it comes to timing things perfectly, because it's really particular about your timing. That saw is annoying too, let me tell you. I'm surprised I didn't hit it the first time. I usually do hit things like that the first time. God damn it! Oh, I'm so close! It's painful! So pent up! Motherfucker. Ah! Okay. Okay, I'm chilling out. I'm calming down. I'm not gonna rage yet. I'm not gonna full-on rage yet anyway. I'm already a little bit raging. But I'm not gonna blow my lid yet. I'm not gonna blow my load all over this game yet. Haha! Okay, I've done it. I know- I'm an idiot. I know that I am an idiot. That is what I know. That is all I know. All I know is that I know nothing, and therefore I know all there is to know. Okay, so I'm pretty sure I figured that jump out. I know I said you can't figure it out, it's just a timing thing. But I mean, I've gotten the timing a little bit better. I've practiced, and God knows I've practiced. Because, man, this game, I've been playing it for so long. This is like the 40th hour I've been playing this game for. I swear to God, I can't handle it anymore. This game... He's killing me. in more ways than one. It's killing me emotionally, but it's also killing me because I had to drink so many freaking cans of Red Bull to get to this point. And it wasn't just Red Bull too. I've done Bing. I've done a weird mixture of Red Bull and Mountain Dew. I don't know if I did Monster once. I had Monster one time, but I don't think it was on this. I don't think it was on this video actually. I don't actually like Monster, and I'm not just saying that like because I'm paid to diss Monster. I'm not being paid by anyone, unfortunately. It would be nice if I was being paid by someone. I just don't like Monster personally. I'm not a big fan of it. At least not the original flavor. I've never tried any other flavors because I didn't like the original, and the original is usually the most popular. But I don't know, I just wasn't a fan of original Monster. You know, the green one. It's just not my thing, man. God damn it, okay. I'm doing okay. I can still do this. It's still doable. I still have time. I still have frickin' a whole hour and 15 minutes. I don't know if I have that much time in terms of how much I can record. I might have to take a break and move the file over, but if I do that, then I'm going to have to start this whole thing over again. But I have that much time in terms of what I have time to record, though. Like, time to be here and do this and not do something else. Alright, this part actually looks easy. I think I can do this. I just have to jump this here, and then jump this here, and then time this right, and then motherfucker. Okay, I'm going to die. I'm going to die on the inside. I just died on the inside a little bit. I died on the inside a long time ago from playing this game, and now I'm just rotting. Now I'm just gradually rotting. What you're watching is not my death, it is my decomposition. I am a decomposing corpse of my former self on this show, honestly. I have been since like episode 3 when this started to actually get hard. Cause like the first frickin' world is a piece of cake, and like I beat it in like a half an hour? I spent a half an hour on the first world, the whole first world. But now I've spent 3 hours on one level, and then I don't know how long I've spent on this frickin' level. Because this is hard too. This is hard as a frickin' rock. This is hard as my dick when I'm looking at Vetra. Okay, maybe cut that out. I don't know. It was a Mass Effect joke. God damn it, okay. Yeah, for the record, that was a joke. But, in all seriousness, Vetra is totally the person I'm choosing to romance in Mass Effect 4. I mean, if you don't choose to romance Vetra, you have a serious mental issue. I'm sorry. You should really get that checked out. You should get some help. Stop it. Just stop it. Get some help. I mean, let's be honest, she's female Garrus. And who would not bang a female Garrus? I mean, come on. Garrus is the shit. Tali was my girl in the first game, or the first 3 games, I should say. And now it's Vetra because Tali's not in this game. I'm pretty sure honestly, as awesome as Vetra is, I'm pretty sure I'd still be picking Tali if Tali was an option. No offense to anyone else, but Tali's awesome. Tali's the best. Tali is undeniably the best. It's not a matter of opinion. No. Usually when someone says, hey, this is the best, it's automatically a matter of opinion, because it's just saying something is good is a matter of opinion. But no, it's a matter of fact that Tali is the best. You cannot deny it. It is undeniable. If you deny it, you are simply preaching false truths. If you try to say that's a matter of opinion, you're just wrong. You are entitled to your opinion, but your opinion is wrong. Tali is the shit. Alright, now that I'm done ranting about Tali in a frickin' Meat Boy video for frickin' 10 minutes, let's focus for a second. How did I manage to go at an angle such that I was, like, almost straight up? I would have had to go almost straight up to frickin' do that. I would have had to been trying to do that, and somehow I've done it 3 times in a row. I'm just, you see, the fact is, I'm not bad at this game, I'm just really good at dying in this game. I've just mastered the art of being killed. Meat Boy's whole purpose is to die, and I'm just really good at it. I've fulfilled my destiny. There is no denying, I am the best at this game, because this game's purpose is to kill you over and over again. And in that regard, I've mastered it. There is no one better than I. Okay, this is going to be a jump of trying to get through those. So, I've done it. I have frickin' done it. Alright, here we go. Here we go. Satellite, radio. That's probably the last time you'll hear me say that, because I'm gonna... Not gonna question this, because it saved my ass, but just gonna say that. Not gonna question it, just point it out. Motherfucker, okay, I'm an idiot. Here we go, here we go. Come on, come on! I'm gonna try not to quote Black Eyed Peas lyrics, in any other series ever. It's pretty much just a hyperspeed thing. I don't know why. It's not like it's an inside joke or a running joke that I'm intentionally perpetuating. It's literally just something I do when I'm hyper as shit. I don't know if that's, like, a good thing about Black Eyed Peas. Like, I just so happen to always quote them when I'm hyper as shit. Like, maybe that's a good thing. Maybe it's because they get me pumped. Maybe because they make me pump it louder. But I'm just saying, I don't know why it happens, but whenever I am on any sort of energy drink, Red Bull included, or frickin' Bing, I just quote Black Eyed Peas lyrics. It's always Black Eyed Peas and Eminem, I don't know why. That first section, the part where you can't die, you just have to make that, like, small jump through that, like, crook there in the side of the thing. I can do that without looking, because, first of all, it's easy. It's the only easy part of this entire level. Easy is not something you usually find in Meat Boy, but this right here, that's easy. That one thing. That is the one easy thing you get. They give it to you as a gift, like, here, I'm going to be kind to you. Since you get to do nothing easily for the entire rest of this game, let's give you this one thing. Just this one. And you know what, Meat Boy, I appreciate it. I really do. I honestly appreciate the easiness. I just wish you would give me more of it. Honestly, I've become an addict. I've become addicted to easy. And you've given me too much easy. Once I've had a taste, I just keep going back. I just keep going back to the easy, see? Clearly, that's why I'm dying. I'm not dying because I'm terrible at this game. I'm not dying because this game is hard as balls. I'm not dying because of that. No, I'm dying because I desire the easiness that is at the beginning of this level. And I just really like to go back to the beginning of the level. I just keep relapsing into easy. And it's just, it's not good for me. I know, it's an addiction, it's killing me. Not slowly, it's killing me fastly and repeatedly. I know I just said fastly, shut up. I know what I said. I'm aware that I'm an idiot. I mean, the first step to recovery is acknowledging you have a problem, and my problem is that I'm an idiot. That is my problem. Motherfucker, kill me now. Oh, I wanna die. Actually, I don't wanna die. I really wanna finish this level. And then I wanna die in real life so I never have to do anything ever like this ever again. If this was my life, I would kill myself. If playing Meat Boy was my life, I would gladly die. I would be like, yes, please. Give me the morphine. Just overdose on it. Please, I'm begging you. I will take it. I'll take it right now. God damn it. Okay. No offense. No intent to... I can't speak. I'm sorry. Okay, now. Okay, so... I'm gonna calm down for a minute. There's smoke just going up my butt there. Okay. I can do this. I swear. It's possible. I know it is. I've done it. I've done it before... And I will do it again. I've done it before once, and I will do it again probably once, and then never again. And then I will never touch Meat Boy ever again. I'm uninstalling this. I swear to God. The end of this video, I swear to God. I swear on my mother's grave, the end of this video will be me uninstalling Super Meat Boy. It's going to be a clip of just Steam. You're just gonna see Steam, and then you're just gonna see me click uninstall because fuck Meat Boy, man. I can't handle it. I can't handle Meat Boy anymore. He's just too much meat for me, I swear. Luckily, this part has gotten rather easy, actually. I say as I almost die in it. I at least understand... Okay, I'm an idiot. I freaking jumped into the alcove there and killed myself. You might notice I like to try to use big words while I, while I frickin' am hyper, but, like, the word alcove, I can't believe I died in that way, by the way, it was the dumbest way possible. I like to try to use big words like alcove, but then also, at the same time, weird words come out of my mouth, like fastly. Yes, thank you. Thank you, grammar, for all you've done for my life. Thank you, English class, for teaching me the bestest of words. The bestest of the words is just kill me now. Actually, don't. Please. Please don't kill me now. I would really like to finish this level. For Christ's sake. I just want to finish this level, and then I can be done forever and ever. I just want it to end. Okay, I have yet to die on that, and I know I'm going to regret saying that because I'm probably going to die very quickly on that at some point in the near future. But I just like to point that out, that I'm not entirely trash because I didn't die on that yet. I at least got past that one easy part without dying every time so far. Every time so far that I've made it there, which is not a lot, honestly. It was two, I think. I think that's the second time I've made it there. Because these frickin' sections here, just like, they just want to ream me, man. They just, I know the definition of ream. I'm not just using that word. It's actually what's happening. It is the definition of what is actually happening to me, is I'm being reamed by this game. It's just, it's taking a rod, like a big metal rod, and just putting it right up there. Okay, I'm gonna take this one slow, alright? I've been trying to rush this one, and that is probably my biggest mistake. So now, I'm just gonna take it slow, and just do this, alright? These saws being in different timing is, like, totally flipping me out, but don't worry, I can still do this. Alright. Ah, I jumped too early. I just jumped too early like a freaking idiot. Like a freaking idiot. Look at how I just mastered that section right there and then immediately killed myself. It's my addiction to the beginning, acting up again. I really like that beginning part where I jump up here and then there's steam going up my ass, see, and coming out my ears. I just really enjoy that feeling of the hotness of the steam just filling me. God damn it, I'm starting to sound really gay. All right. Honestly, like I would prefer a dick up my ass to this game, and that's not because I'm gay. That's because this game is gay. This game, I've reverted to like frickin' seventh grade insults, like when I don't like something to just immediately call it gay. And let me tell you, I'm not gonna judge, man. Do what you want with your life. You're not. I have nothing against you for liking things like that. It's just, I don't want to be mean, but like, I'm sorry. I'm just, this game reverts me to a 12-year-old, and my 12-year-old sense of humor just comes back. It's no offense intended. I can't handle this. Just like when I'm this unbelievably stressed out, I just can't handle it. I really can't. I just start saying idiotic crap, and it's nothing personal, man. I'm sorry. I'm really sorry for what I said. I just really want this to end. I'm just so close. I just want to finish. I just want to be set free from this pain. From this frickin' torment, this pain and torture that I've endured for all this time. God damn it. Kill me now. I'm just not ready for this emotionally. I was never ready for this, and I never will be ready for this emotionally. Well, I just learned for a fact that those explosions, in fact, do not kill you. I just learned that because I just got hit directly by one. Those little explosions that happen that are just like animations for the background, they do not hurt you. That is something I have clearly established. And look! I finally broke my streak of making it through there every time. I mean, 2 out of 3 ain't bad. I mean, it's basically the, What's that show? The Naked... How I Met Your Mother. I don't know why I said, what's that show? I've watched every episode of it. I love that show. Except for the finale. The finale is terrible. I mean, let's be honest. The alternate ending's okay. You know, the one where the mother, actually, you know what? I should probably just shut up in case you haven't watched it. Just watch the show. It's a good show. I won't spoil it. But anyway, there's that one episode with the naked man. God damn it. Okay. Anyway, it's like the naked man. It works 2 out of 3 times, guaranteed. Guaranteed. I just have to make it there 2 more times and then I can die again. You know what I mean? You know what I'm saying? I mean, that's clearly my goal in life, is to just show that statistic is true. My goal in life is to die 3 out of 2 times. I don't even know what I'm saying anymore, I'll be entirely honest. I just jumped right into that. I didn't even try to do anything. I was just standing there and I was like, you know what? Just end it. Just end my life here. I know I'm gonna die anyway, so why should I bother trying? And then I just jumped right into this saw. I just jumped directly into the saw. Like, I didn't even attempt to do anything other than just jump directly into the saw. I was like, just claim my life now. You're going to take it. You are inevitably going to take my life. Just take it now. Just make it quick, please. Just end it. End it quickly. That is my only request. Just end it. Just stop the torture. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Look at how easy this section has gotten for me. That section right there is like a piece of cake for me now. Like, that is a cakewalk. I'm walking on cake. Walking on sunshine. Whoa, whoa, whoa. And don't it feel good? No, it don't. It don't feel good. Please. Please, just end it. It do not feel good. I can't handle it. I can't handle it. I really can't. I really cannot handle this game. Oh, I don't know why I'm so happy. I just made that thing that I've done a million times. I don't know, maybe I just realized that, like, maybe I'm not entirely trash. Just maybe. Nope. But nope. Then I go and prove that I am trash. I just went and right and proved it by dying twice in a row in the dumbest possible spots. Two of the dumbest possible spots. Two of the stupidest things I could have done, and I just did it right away. Because, man, I'm just not allowed to feel good. You know, it's not within the laws of what is capable. That sentence did not make any... Put that up as a quote on the screen. It's not within the laws of what is capable. Because that just didn't make any sense. That was the best quote of all time. Deepest quote ever. I'm just the greatest quote machine. Like, on the list of good things that release good quotes, you have, like, Abraham Lincoln, and then you have, like, Christopher Nolan's Batman trilogy, and then you have me, and I'm just so much better than both of those things. I produce the most massive amount of flawless quotes, just like that. Like, I'm just so incredible at creating quotes, man. It's just, like, that's deep, man. Like, I don't know if you, I don't, like, I don't know if you know deep quotes, but man, there is no quote deeper than the things that I say. Okay, let's stop talking about my quotes. In fact, let's stop talking altogether, because I'd like to actually beat this. Why did I do that? Why did I do that? I don't know. I don't know why I did that. I just chose to do that. I just chose to play this again. I was just like, you know, if I beat this now, this episode's gonna be too short. If I beat this now, this episode will actually be under 3 hours long. And I can't have that. That can't be a thing that's gonna happen. No. No, this episode needs to be fucking 6 hours long. No. I'm just gonna make it 6 hours long. Screw it. Screw it, man. Just screw this episode. Just screw me. Just screw me with a rake. Alright, I think I've at least got that part down. I say as I jump into the one thing I have not hit yet. I just really wanted to get blood on every single saw. It's my goal. Speaking of getting blood on the saws, why the heck isn't blood getting on these saws? It's not showing the blood thing like it usually does. I don't know why. That's odd. It must be a glitch. It's a visual glitch. It's not a big deal though. Alright, I need to stop being so hyper. I know this is hyperspeed. But for the best of... For the sake of ending this episode within a semi-reasonable amount of time, I need to stop being the hyper. Because it's killing me. So I'm gonna calm down. And I'm gonna play this seriously. Okay. Nope. Nope. I'm calming down. Here we go. I don't know why I did that. Don't question me. Don't question my authority. No one's allowed to question my authority. I'm the master of dying in Super Meat Boy. I can do it like nobody else. Nobody else is as good at dying as I am, let me tell you. I'm just the best at everything, except for winning this game, apparently. I'm pretty terrible at that. But we don't acknowledge that here. Here on Hyperspeed, we don't acknowledge the things I'm bad at, only the things I'm really good at. Like dying. Like failing. At life. That's a thing that I'm good at. Yeah, I've gone quiet because I'm gonna actually beat this now. Okay, I'm gonna take my time with this. I have all the time in the world. There are no saws chasing me anymore. At least, they're not chasing me. There's a lot of saws, but they're not chasing me. So I'm gonna beat this. On this try. This one. Yes. On this try. Not that one. I never intended to beat it on that try. It was always my objective to die. No. That really screwed me up, and I lost the timing there. Whew, okay. Okay. Oh. Okay, well, at least I touched the wall. If touching the wall was my goal, I would succeed every time, because I've always touched a wall somewhere. Every single attempt I've made, I have touched a wall. I've also touched a saw every single attempt I've made, because saw is the only thing that can kill you in this. Oh, well, actually, that's not true. That's not true. I've fallen down a couple times. I've fallen off the map a few times. Okay, my heart is racing, and I'm having trouble breathing at a normal pace, but don't worry, I'll be fine. As long as I don't die, I will be fine. Yeah, that's a very logical statement. Hey guys, as long as I don't die, I'll be fine. Why did they put those saws in such a way that makes you want to jump prematurely? They put those saws specifically in a way such that if you try to have a rhythm there, you're not going to be able to do it. I don't know why I tried to have a rhythm. That was dumb. That was a mistake. I should have just taken my time and freaking done it the right way. And I swear to God, next time I get there, I will do it the right way. I will take my freaking time and do it. That jump is not even hard. That one right there, honestly, is pretty easy. I'm just playing jump rope, don't mind me. Okay, it's screwed up my timing again, but that's fine. I can still do it. Ah! Okay, I'm done. I'm done freaking out. I swear to God. I swear to God. I'm gonna kill myself. Okay. Okay. That's okay. That's fine. No comment. I don't even know what I just did there, but it was weird, and I guess I'm fine with it. I have to accept it, because I cannot reject it. I have no option to reject. There is no reject button. There is no option to beat the game. There is no button to press Super Meat Boy and be like, you know what, I refuse to die. I'm just gonna come back. I'm feeling like freaking playing Undertale, and you're fighting Sans, and it's like, Never give up. Trust your instincts. Yeah, that's Undertale. That's an Undertale reference, definitely. I'm definitely not referencing another peppy quote from Star Fox. That's not the case. If that were the case, I would be bad at this game. And clearly those two things are both false. It's kind of like a... What's the opposite of an XOR? It's like an inverted XOR. It can only... If they're both the same, it's true. If they're both false, it's true. And clearly those things are not the same. Clearly those things are not true. Clearly I am not bad at this game, and therefore, obviously I'm not quoting, Star Fox, because I would only quote Star Fox if I was bad at this game, and I'm not. I'm great at this game. You can go back and rewatch this, and you can count all the times that I've quoted Star Fox, and it's gonna come up to zero because I'm good at this game. Okay, this is fine, I still made it. Whew, okay. I am still alive. At this point, as of now, I am still alive. I'm just gonna jump that. Okay, this section is gonna be mildly difficult. Okay, I'm still alive. Guys, I am still alive. I don't know. Place your bets now. Will I beat it on this try? Look, this is the beginning of the level. I'm about to win. Place your bets now. Place your mother frickin' bets now. Oh my god. Oh my god. If you bet that I was going to win, congratulations, you had the 0 to a billion odds and somehow you were right. I frickin' did it. I don't know how I did it. It's blown my frickin' mind. I am shaking. I am literally shaking. Oh, hey, the squirrel survived. Aw. Aw. Good. That made it all worth it. And by worth it, I meant... I have a question. Do you think eating enough candle would kill you? Because that's my current plan. I could just... Actually, that candle smells really good. I don't know. That's actually a pretty delicious smelling candle. Hey, he's alive too! Oh, never mind. I mean, he's probably still alive. He's taken worse torture than just having a toilet land on him. So, he's probably still alive. And all those meat boys that died are all partying in hell. I'm glad I gave you so many friends to hang out with in hell. I'm glad I sent so many meat boys down there to be with you, to make you happy. I'm glad. Okay, that's not good. That does not make me happy. I would prefer that thing remain dead, personally. Oh, hey. Me and Bandit's girl can finally be together in love with this really poorly shaped heart. With this,
The end?
Question mark. Find out in the dark. It's the end. I promise you it is the end. I am never coming back to this game ever again. Screw you. Screw your game. I'm out. I am done. It's over. No. 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 Look, boss is dead. You can see it right there. The boss is dead. I have proved it. It's over. No, 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 never. I'm actually shaking. I'm not doing this for, like, comedic effect. I'm actually shaking right now. So, hey. How's it going, guys? I'm glad you've joined me on this extremely painful journey. I hope it was as painful for you as it was for me, and with my idiotic babbling the entire time, I'm sure it was as painful for you as it was for me. Actually, that's not true. Nothing was as painful as what just happened. Nothing. Nothing was as painful as what just happened. If you had anal sex with a porcupine, it would be less painful than what happened. If an echidna bit off your dick, it would be less painful than what just happened. If you were exposed to radiation and grew a third arm, which then ripped your scrotum off and fed it to you, it would not be as painful as what just happened. Okay? Okay. If I bit into this candle, glass and all, and swallowed it, and somehow survived, and didn't go to the emergency room, and didn't get painkillers, and just lived the rest of my life with glass just sliding down my throat gradually, it would be less painful than what just happened. Okay? Okay. If I used this clip to pinch the tip of my dick, and then pulled it until it was all the way at the extent of my arm's reach, well, my dick would be long enough to still be out that far, so. God damn it. I'm done. It's just hitting me just now that I finally beat Meat Boy. Holy crap. I'm crying, guys. These are tears of joy. I can leave now. So you know what? I'm gonna finish this off with a glorious hurrah and a beautiful thank you for watching. And stay interesting. Alright, where's the bleach? Yep. These are definitely pills that will kill me and not just a box of Tums. I'm gonna, I know I'm gonna go hang myself with this frickin' Wii remote. I'll see you later.